on ESPN2. You can flip over every now and then and keep up with the Australian Open. But we are set for tip-off in Lawrence. Brett Musburger and Bob Knight have the call.
53 and counting. Kansas has not lost at home since 2007. And tonight, the Jayhawks welcome an ancient foe, Missouri. The border showdown has remained hostile for over a century. And the students here in Lawrence have been camped out most of the week, waiting for a chance to come in and hope the Jayhawks can beat the Tigers again. It's all part of ESPNU Campus Connection Week.
ESPNU Campus Connection Week.
The crowd is going bananas.
U-C-O-N-N.
Has it dented the Tar Heels' confidence?
I recently spoke with Gerald Henderson.
Students giving you an all-access pass to campus life across the country.
I still feel like we're the best.
This is our house.
We welcome you to ESPN Big Monday. It's a madhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Presented by Bud Light. It's part of ESPNU Campus Connection Week on ESPN. Tonight, the Missouri Tigers travel here to Lawrence to take on the number two team in the nation. And Missouri can grab a share of first place in the Big 12 with an upset here tonight as they come in 3-1 in the conference. Good evening, everybody, and welcome with my Hall of Fame coach, Bob Knight, and I hope he can hear me here tonight. I've never heard an arena this loud. I'm Brett Musburger. Bob, when you come into an environment like this, how important is a good start for Missouri here in the opening minutes?
Well, I think it's really important because they've got to neutralize the crowd a little bit. They've got to let Kansas know that they're in a game. If they get started off poorly, it just fans a flame for Kansas to really go after them.
When you're the road coach, do you treat the referees any differently in one like this?
You know, I never knew who was going to officiate Brent until I walked out on the floor for the tip-off. And even then, sometimes I saw who was officiating and wanted to go back to the locker room.
Let's take a look at our lineups here tonight, presented by Radio Shack. First from Missouri, the freshman from Kansas City, the number one recruit from Missouri, Michael Dixon, moves into the starting lineup. As far as the Jayhawks are concerned, this is a familiar starting five. But note, please, number 22, one of the Morris twins, Marcus, is red hot. He is the leading scorer since Big 12 play began. He's been on fire. Let us go to the third member of our team right now, Holly Rowe. Holly.
We're talking about that crazy style that Missouri plays. They thrive on making their opponents uncomfortable. So to prepare for this game, Bill Self last night had his team practicing against eight guys on the scout team. Furthermore, he wouldn't stop action. Guys were getting tackled. It was so physical. Afterwards, he told his team, look, you've got to know the officials are not going to call fouls. I do not want to see you looking over at the bench. I want good, positive body language. But just get ready to know this is going to be a physical ball game. Guys, that's what they're ready for. After all, it's the border war. It shouldn't be easy.
Ladies and gentlemen, just sit back and enjoy. I'm going to turn this crowd loose here as we get started. You'll see the key players. Journey begins. Kansas with the first possession. Henry will feed the post. Cole Aldridge coming off a great game against Iowa State. Up with the game's first shot, and he's fouled. He'll shoot a pair of free throws.
You know, I always thought that what you want to do on the first possession is have a really good chance to score, and I think that's what Kansas set up. They went into Aldridge. Aldridge had a good little fake and a turnaround move to draw the foul. Now, if the first possession yields 2 points, then Kansas has done all it can to get off to a start. Aldridge has a really strange, I would not recommend to a youngster to go through all of the motion, body motion and arm motion that Aldridge does with the free throw, but he's a very good free throw shooter with what he does.
Hit one of two after the Ramsey foul, and now young Dixon brings it down the floor to set the table here for the Tigers. Just their first shot, one and done, into the hands of Morningstar. Up at the floor to Henry, who saved it.
Missouri will not slow down the pace of the game at all.
Oh, bangs it home.
That's one of those passes that led to a bucket.
Ramsey is sealed up. Held ball. Missouri with the possession arrow.
In 40 seconds, Brent, at the start of the game, Kansas could have not asked for a better start.
Missouri needs to settle down, and young Dixon misfires from the perimeter.
Missouri's just a little bit leery of Aldridge inside blocking his shot. Kansas has a tremendous advantage in the season in shot blocks over its opponent's shot blocks.
Ramsey fires the three ball. Is good, and they're on the board. Missouri has tied it.
Well, that's a pretty good move for Missouri because they tried to take Aldridge outside. Ramsey did, and Cole did not go with him, and Ramsey stuck the three in. It was a good thing for their offense.
High pick and roll. Aldridge now rotates back to the block. Backs his way into the paint. Everything happened except it didn't stay down. Ramsey has it stolen by X. Up the floor quickly now to Sharon Collins. Henry, one of the talented freshmen this year, slashes. And he was tied up in underneath, but it will be Jayhawk ball here, Bob. And there is Mike Anderson. Fourth season as the Missouri head coach. Turned down a lot of extra money when Georgia came a-calling. He told us today after practice his family very comfortable, and really nice to see the loyalty as Missouri gave him a chance. And he's done a good job. We've got it out of bounds. Stepping on the line over there, Coach.
Well, that was a result of a good trap on the inbounds pass that Missouri made. And we're going to see Missouri trap a lot, I think, Brent, both when they get to full court pickup and also as they did there with the half court pickup.
Taylor slashes. Back to Tiller, great pass in low, and Safford puts Missouri up for the first time today.
You know, it was a really good pass by Tiller, but Safford made a great cut into an open spot and then converted to a bucket.
There is Morris. Marcus Morris rattles back out.
Well, Kansas had missed two really good opportunities, one with Morris and the other with Aldridge inside.
Another three ball, and it is knocked down again. This one, Keith Ramsey from Murfreesboro, Tennessee, and it's an 8-3. There's that good start you talked about, Bob.
Well, they did it in spite of a really good beginning for Kansas. Missouri has stung right in there and actually got the best out of these first 3 minutes.
Mike Anderson's teams always hustle. Made it to a regional final last year, knocked out by Connecticut.
Kansas will go out and set a ball screen after they've made a couple of passes. But Missouri did a very good job there of staying with the ball.
Aldridge is fouled again. They doubled down on the reception that time, and a reach-in foul is called. So they're obviously going to attack him down to the post. They do not have the height to match up against Bill Self's pivot man, and so they're using a lot of double teams down low.
You know, the key to double teaming the post man is that when the pass is going, that second guy has got to get down and not give him any room to move, and they've done that thus far. Missouri has.
Marcus Morris out on a pick and roll. X doesn't get it back to him.
Boy, Taylor is doing a very good job in half court defense on Henry.
Henry will come up and fire the three ball.
Nails it. And then did not get inside or went inside to help out. And Henry was alone and took the shot immediately, caught it, had his feet set, and hit the three.
Rebound Kansas into Henry's hands.
Missouri's got to get a better shot than that one. That was kind of a wasted possession for him there.
Sharon Collins has been quiet here so far. Down in low now, and Marcus could not finish. He's 0 for 2 starting tonight.
Boy, it's a great look by Morningstar inside, though.
The freshman whistled up an air ball into Marcus's hands. Now Morningstar hard down the wing. Pull up three. Tap back by X, out of bounds. Goes to Missouri.
I think it may be Kansas ball with a timeout.
So they've got a quick break down here, and Mike Anderson working with his freshman. You can see him giving the young man a start here tonight because he did play well in an early rivalry game against Illinois. And, of course, Dixon, number 10, represents a lot of the future of this Missouri team. And he shows some calm out here tonight. He has picked up one foul, that reach in on the double team, but he was not afraid to take a shot, even though it was an air ball.
Well, you know, what's really impressed me about Missouri here, they have worked quickly, but they've worked well to get shots. And with the exception of one shot that Safford took, I think they've gotten good shots, and that's why they got into an early lead in this ball game. But there has been nothing hesitant about the Tigers on the offensive end of the floor.
So their leading scorer, who did not start here tonight, English, checks into the game. Kim English averaging 15 points a game. He's hit 109 threes for the Tigers, hitting 37% of his three-point shots.
Missouri's going to use a very tight zone setup and make them throw the ball out and then jump into it. They still stay, I think, in the zone. They're in a little 2-3 zone. Try to match up a little bit on the perimeter, play the ball man-to-man.
Now both Morrises are out. Number 21, the identical twin. Here's Markeith down on the low block. Kicks it back outside. Collins, three, rattled out. And in to the hands of Marcus Dinman, who's on the floor. Here comes Dixon, penetrating, slapping, throws it up. What a good-looking freshman he is.
Nixon is very, very quick with the ball.
And Collins brings it down to Taylor. Taylor misses, but underneath, that is Marcus Morris. His first hoop of the evening. I got to bet with him that I don't misidentify him once tonight.
I don't think you will. You don't misidentify very many people.
I did a couple of times against California. That's why he teased me. Dixon in and out and into brother Markeith's hands. The twins from Philadelphia. Morningstar looks in. Marcus coming back up on top. Here's Markeith. He hits his brother, Marcus, and one.
Now that was a great recognition of the double team. When Missouri doubled down, the ball went inside, and there was a cut made that enabled them to get a three-point try opportunity because of a good pass.
When we come back, a little bit more on the border showdown between Kansas and Missouri.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. With a just right taste that's not too heavy, not too light, the difference is drinkability.
Well, this showdown between Missouri and Kansas deadlocked here in the early going. But I want to tell you, folks, this rivalry is real. This is not trumped up. This is not imagination of a sports writer. This goes way back when there were skirmishes over whether Kansas would enter the Union as a free state or a slave state. They were on opposite sides because Kansas came into the Union as a free state. And that was merely the beginning of hostilities. This town was burned to the ground by the famous Quantrill's Raiders. I mean, blood was shed in this one. And coach who rode with Quantrill?
I think the James boys rode with Quantrill, and they were Missourians by birth and by where they lived.
Indeed they were. They came over here, and of course, after the Civil War, hostilities quieted down considerably, and now, more than a century later, they still are arch rivals in athletics as Marcus Morris nails the free throw, and he has 5 points here That was a foul on Denman that sent him to the free throw line. Three team fouls here on Missouri now.
Marcus got a great pass from his brother to set up that three-point situation. His brother, as we said, was double-teamed inside and found the cutter.
Mike Anderson uses a lot of players on this team. Frequently goes back to the bench. They'll play 10-11 here tonight. And on the run-in, Bowers off that bench scores. Lawrence Bowers out of Memphis, Tennessee, a city that has turned out some great basketball talent through the years.
Bowers made an excellent drive on the baseline. He caught it with a little fake up high. And there, Missouri makes a really good switch on the outside of the Kansas offense.
Poor pass by Kansas. Turn it over, and Missouri comes back down, leading it by a point. Here is young Paul. He had 15 the other night against Nebraska. And rotating in was Markeith Morris. Ball in his hands. Brother Marcus is now on the bench, and Taylor is fouled.
Missouri's averaging a little over 21 threes a game, and they've not been hesitant in putting it up from outside. But I do think that one thing they're going to have to do, Brent, is go inside a little bit. They got a good inside move for a bucket on a drive, and I think they're going to have to get some stuff inside, go into the bucket, and get to the free throw line.
Hey, Holly, I tried to get Tyshawn Taylor's Facebook account today, and I couldn't find it. What happened?
Well, that's because it no longer exists. After a little incident where somebody reported that they saw on his Facebook account that he was going to transfer, or words to that effect, although Bill Self said they never substantiated that. They just had him take it down. And Coach Self said, you know, he's a good kid. He just can't seem to get out of his own way. But, you know, in the other breath, he said, if a kid wants to transfer, I'll be the first one to help him. He thinks Taylor just needs to stop talking and do his talking on the court.
Yeah, he was one of the youngsters that got into a little bit of a hassle with the football players here in Lawrence, too. All right, Missouri brings it up now. They trail the Jayhawks by a point. Here's Paul. They go to the trap, and a pushing foul has been called as Sharon Collins tried to close in on the sideline over there.
Every once in a while, it's really interesting to see a pressing team be pressed and see how they react well to it. Now, Kansas almost had a trap set at midcourt there, and the foul was called before they could really execute the trap.
13-12, Jayhawks up by one on the Tigers. Tigers basketball, if you just joined us, 13-27 here.
Missouri does a really good job coming off what I call a tight cut, most people a curl cut, into the lane.
Bowers didn't get it to fall. Henry brings it down for the Jayhawks. Tyrell Reed out there now, also for Coach Self. No, wave it off. He traveled. X traveled, and Aldridge comes back into the game for Kansas.
Henry slipped just a bit going up into the air to take the shot, and that slip was a definite walk. That was a really good observation and call.
That's fourth turnover here in the early going for the Jayhawks.
Well, Missouri has shown no hesitancy to play in this game thus far.
Aldridge with a block. Outlet pass Taylor. Reed's on the other side. Elliott, a beautiful play from the defensive end on the block to the other end on the alley-oop. Gorgeous basketball.
That's one area we mentioned earlier where Kansas has a definite advantage over most everybody they play, and that's shot blocking.
They turned it over again. X on the roll. He'll battle his way in. Off his leg and out of bounds. That was terrific defense. No foul was called by John Higgins. Self thought for sure there was a hacking foul that was missed. Take a look here.
We got him on the arm. That wasn't a slap on the ball. That was a slap on the wrist.
So Missouri says, thank you very much. We'll take it. Driving down the baseline and coming to the free throw line right now is Justin Safford, the junior from Bloomington. The crowd still voicing its displeasure at the lack of a call on the other end, and Self is out there asking for an explanation.
Aldridge was just slow coming across to help out here. You're going to see here where he does get a piece of his arm. There's no question. but at the other end, Aldridge was a little bit slow coming out to help, and he was at a poor angle, and Safford really took advantage of it to get to the line.
So Aldridge picking up his first. Safford missing his first free throw for Missouri.
When you come to help, it's really important, Brett, that you get squared off, that you don't let the guy that you're helping on have an advantage going to the bucket, and Aldridge did there. With a squared up stance, he was going to be able to stop his penetration. Now, this is the first time that Missouri's really gone after Kansas with the press.
And this is what the Jayhawks practiced. Holly told you about. They just attack, attack, attack. And Marcus Morris scores against that press.
That was great handwork by Morris. He tipped the ball twice so he could get control of it and then had enough balance to make the bucket. That was a tremendous athletic play.
Paul on the pull-up, a little bit short on the shot, and quickly the Jayhawks come back. Here's Reed. He is cut off by Paul, throws it up into Bauer's hands. Probably should have reset the play from the baseline. English, alley-oop! No, can't finish. Here comes Henry for the Jayhawks.
I think Missouri's going to have to slow down just a little bit here when they go to the offensive end and work things a bit to see if they can't get to the free throw line.
Marcus steps out. Aldridge is tied up by Paul, and the foul is called. They had the little man on the big man, and he tied him up down low and picked up the personal. Well, Marcus Morris, one of the twins from Philadelphia. And let him show you, as Bob Knight pointed out, great effort and why he was such a highly recruited youngster along with his brother. Time out. Kansas searching for its 54th consecutive victory at home with a four-point lead right now. And you know, during ESPNU Campus Connection Week, students from the participating universities are doing extra credit to give us a little insight into their lives on campus. Let's check in now with Will Maitzold from the University of Mizzou.
Welcome to Missouri, and one of the traditions we have here involves the David R. Francis statue back here right across from the Francis Quadrangle. If you rub his nose and you go to Mizzou, you're supposed to get an A on your next test. I don't have any tests coming up. It's the beginning of the semester, but the Missouri basketball team, for them playing Kansas, usually a big test. So I'm going to rub the nose for them, and there we go. Now they have the luck of David R. Francis on their side. For now, from Mizzou, I'm Will Metzold of Palestra.net for ESPNU Campus Connection.
That's a pretty heavily rubbed nose there.
Yeah. I think that boy better study harder rather than rub noses.
Well, there are a handful of Missouri fans, but they are surrounded by the Jayhawkers here. There's one of the loneliest Tiger fans we could find.
Looked like maybe two brothers, one for Kansas and one for Missouri.
So it will be Jayhawks ball. Sharon Collins sends it deep to Morningstar. 11 minutes left, 17-13.
Zoned the out of bounds again and then stayed with it.
Sharon Collins with a tough shot, but Aldridge digs it out. Morningstar tries to hit Morris, and Marcus couldn't reach that one. That's a sixth turnover here today by the Jayhawks.
Morningstar had a terrible angle on that pass. That was one where he should. See, so often, Brent, I think we can get that halfway pull-up jump shot, that 12-foot jump shot, rather than going beyond that. And that's something that's a little bit of a lost art.
Missing the three ball, and Aldridge had it knocked away from him. It'll be Kansas basketball.
All right, Missouri's going to go all out with their press again. This is the second time they've looked at full-court pickup.
So Marcus will put it down. Bill said you attack it two ways, with the pass and the dribble. Marcus probably keeping his hands a little too long. Finally gets it up to Morningstar. Morningstar! Nice little scoop shot.
And he made a very good body move, good athletic move to get away from the defensive man.
So Tiller knocks it down, and now we're at that point where Missouri needs a basket. They've slipped back by six. Bowers coming down baseline, jumps it into the post, back outside. Pull up by English, and he's short, and Aldridge got another rebound. What a great outlet pass. Hits Collins at midcourt, and here comes X. And he is fouled. Tiller got him. Bob, let's go back to what you were talking about here.
All right, we're going to see it. We're going to see a feed into the post. No, we're going to go against the zone here. Now, Kansas does a good job. Patience, get a little breakaway. Morningstar attacks the bucket, makes a real good athletic move to his right to get the basket. And Aldridge did a great job on that last possession defensively. Missouri was just a little bit afraid to go in on top of him, and that's what ended up in an outside shot.
Dangerous pass, out of bounds. Sharon Collins a little bit shaky here in the backcourt, wouldn't you say, Coach, in the early going?
Well, you know, that's, I always called that a cheap pass. You know, you're looking for something cheap, and there isn't much that's out here cheap against a team like Missouri. Let's take a little bit more time and make a really good pass.
Dixon back on the floor, misfires a three, and Aldridge has gone to work on the defensive glass, dominating the smaller Missouri team. Morningstar off the dribble again, comes to the left side.
Morningstar has done a great job in terms of what he's been able to do to get to the bucket against that full court pickup or in conversion to the offensive end. All right, here's what Aldridge really does as good as anybody in the country, the outlet pass. Now here, Morningstar took a little bit more time, a little bit more cautious, and Morris did a great job screening out the defensive postman that enabled Morningstar to get to the bucket.
Well, a reminder, tomorrow, catch a Big Ten SEC doubleheader on ESPN Super Tuesday. First at 7 Eastern, Michigan State goes down and plays the Michigan Wolverines. Manny Harris will be back for that game. 9 Eastern, Kentucky, the only unbeaten team left, goes up against South Carolina. Super Tuesday presented by KFC. And the duel that you will be watching, of course, the freshman sensation, John Wall, averaging 17 points. Devin Downey, red hot the other night against the Gators, but Florida pulled it out at the buzzer. Dixon back on the floor, stays on. And Missouri is one of those points of the game when they badly need a field goal.
Aldridge is always lurking inside, and they're very much aware of that, although he makes a heck of a drive right there. Tiller was very strong with his move to the bucket.
At the other end, there's that man again, Morningstar, and Marcus Morris for a driving layup. Morningstar has done a fabulous job on the floor here.
Well, this is where Missouri's press is helping Kansas, not Missouri. You're going to see here where they get a breakaway. Now, the full court play, the long outlet passes by Aldridge, what Morningstar's done with the ball has really put Kansas in the position they're in right now with an 8-point lead that could be 9.
So Marcus Morris, 6'8". The Morrises are sophomores.
No, the full court pickup, Brent, just gives a team that's fast and can handle the ball well a lot of opportunities to score.
Oh, there is Cole Aldridge again. Sharon Collins tapped back. Marcus couldn't flush it. Crowd ready to explode at any moment here. Bad pass saved.
Morris just needed to gather himself there instead of trying to make the shot with the jump.
Missouri has just had a terrible time, and they wave it off.
Got a push on Aldridge. He had Aldridge pushed under the bucket, did it with his right arm on the push.
And that push was on Bowers, so he'll pick up. That's his first, and it's going to be shooting one-on-one time as we come up to the other end. 700 career rebounds for Cole Aldridge.
You know, one of the toughest fouls from a coaching standpoint to see, Brent, is a foul at your offensive end that allows the opponent to go to the other end and score a couple of points. And that's what Aldridge has an opportunity to do here. That's 1 point on a Missouri possession. Now he's going to get a second opportunity, and if he makes this one, he's gotten 2 points on a Missouri possession, not a Kansas possession.
Another big number, Coach, that you talk about always, 18 fouls on Missouri and only 2 on Kansas. And so the Jayhawks shooting that one-on-one, even though he missed the second one here. Now Missouri just having a terrible time trying to score the basketball from the perimeter.
Kansas defense has been very good. They're playing on the three-point line. They're not extending themselves from where they can't go.
Tiller inside to Bowers. Look at Aldridge. Battle away. Rip it away. Here's Collins now at the attack end. Stutter step. Score. Dixon passes it up.
I really like the way Kansas is set up on the three-point line. Rather than the further out you go, the more room you give quick guards with the ball a chance to get past you.
There's Bowers draining a big three. Tigers in desperate need of a field goal. That's five for Bowers, and it's 26-18.
Morris was very slow going out on Bowers that time. That was the poorest defense that Kansas has had on half court.
Markieff Morris now underneath, and he is fouled by Missouri. Now watch Cole Aldridge here battle. What an impressive big man he has become through the years. And that two-handed outlet, a la Wes Unseld. Timeout.
I'm Reese Davis, SportsCenter right now, presented by Sprint. Man, Georgetown looked great against Syracuse for about 3 minutes. Then it was all orange. Number four, Syracuse blows out the Hoyas 73-56. Wesley Johnson, 14 points and 9 rebounds. In the NBA, Dwayne Wade, LeBron James head-to-head. 30 for Wade, 26 for Bron. They are tied at 69, fourth quarter just underway. SportsCenter coming up after the game. Stay current with ESPN News.
And here in Lawrence, Kansas, the Jayhawks lead Missouri 26-18 in a Big 12 game. And a reminder that college basketball continues with the Big East ACC doubleheader on Wednesday night hoops on ESPN. Notre Dame Villanova for the Big East will start it at 7 Eastern, followed by Florida State and Duke at 9 Eastern, all part of ESPNU Campus Connection Week on ESPN. Just to finish up some bookkeeping, Ramsey has picked up 3 personal fouls for Missouri in this game. And here is Markieff Morris on the free throw line for the Jayhawks.
You know, at this point, there's a real mathematical explanation for the score. Missouri 7 out of 25 from the floor. Kansas is 10 of 23. Missouri's made 1 free throw. Kansas made 5. Missouri has 11 rebounds. Kansas has 23. Missouri has 2 turnovers. Kansas 7. That's the only spot where they're a little bit ahead of Kansas. But the mathematics so far really favor Kansas.
Tiller kicks it into the corner. Battled his way in for the field goal, and Zaire comes up with 2, and now a little token pressure in that backcourt.
Taylor did a great job worming his way into the basket, and so did Kansas Taylor right there.
Yes, indeed, as Tyshawn Taylor for the Jayhawks out of Hoboken, New Jersey.
Kansas defense is not as good with Aldridge out of the game. They just don't have anybody that's got his movement and his strength inside to cover up, to rebound, to block shots.
Very good point, because instead that time, as Safford came in, it wasn't a block shot, it was a foul on Kansas.
Well, and just before that, when the possession before, that's when Taylor made his squirrel move into the basket and got a bucket. So with Aldridge on the bench, Missouri has had a chance at 4 points inside. Now Aldridge is coming right back.
He and Marcus Morris, the two big men, will be checking back in here. Robinson and Markieff Morris will lead.
Aldridge just has a really good concept of defense in the lane, post defense and help defense. He's very active. He positions himself very well. He knows where the ball is, and he knows where the driving lane is, and that's why he's such a good shot blocker and changes so much inside with his size.
Safford knocks down that free throw. An 8-point Jayhawk advantage here. Knocked out of bounds. 28 on the shot. Sharon Collins they have done a good job so far, Bob, in handling him. Sharon only one of five from the floor, no assists and a couple of turnovers. So Missouri deserves a lot of credit for working on the All-American guard who's bringing it up right now for the Jayhawks. Number four out of Chicago.
You know, Kansas has gotten a lot of good play out of Morningstar. Morningstar has done a lot of things in the break and conversion offense that usually Collins does, so he's really taken up a lot of slack.
Double three defenders go down.
Back outside for the three ball by Reed. Tyrell Reed.
See, Aldridge again has that presence. He's triple teamed inside. He keeps the ball up high, looking for where he can throw it.
Comes down with a defensive rebound right away. Occupies that low block. One of the many reasons, Bob, why this team is favored to go so far in the NCAAs. I mean, many people preseason picked them to cut down the nets in Indianapolis.
I'll tell you, Aldridge has got a great feel for whichever end of the floor that he is. Down at the other end, he doesn't throw it away on the outlet pass. He makes a shorter outlet here. Look at the pass he makes for the three. Triple teamed, he knows where somebody is and finds it.
Collins sends it deep to Taylor, and Sharon comes back out on top to take the return. Here is Taylor trying to work his way to the doghouse. And Marcus Morris comes down with another field goal.
Taylor making that drive was looking at Morris all the way.
Great spin by Taylor. Can't come loose. Tied up underneath. And a foul, I believe.
Foul for number 22.
That's Marcus Morris.
The foul was on the spin. You mentioned the spin move that he made, and Morris got a piece of him on the spin.
Yep, so Marcus Morris picks up his first, I believe, of the evening.
And you know, here another thing, Brent, here we are with a little over five minutes to play, and Missouri has not yet gotten into the 1-1 with all the defensive pressure and the inside defense that Kansas has played. That's pretty good keeping a team out of the 1-1 for 15 minutes.
Yeah, about to follow up on that, only 14 fouls against Kansas. Tiller with that spin move, missed on the shot, and offensive rebound, long rebound, and Missouri will try to reset it here. Safford jumping into Bowers, and Bowers couldn't put it away because of Aldridge. And now Aldridge blocks his shot in underneath. That is four blocks for Cole Aldridge, number 45.
Just
stolen that pass. Headman. And one as JT Tiller out of Marietta, Georgia. Got down the floor for the layup and drew the foul, Coach.
Just knowing that Aldridge is there makes it difficult for Missouri to do anything inside.
So it's always nice when he's not there.
Yeah, exactly. And to begin with here, this started with a bad Kansas pass. A little bit too hurried. They made a pass they didn't need to make. You know, you got that big kid. Give him a chance to get down the floor, too. You don't need to try to score without him because you're going to score a lot easier when he gets down there. So I think when you've got a kid that moves, can see, can pass, can do what Aldridge can do inside, unless you've got a clear-cut break, just hold the ball up and let him get in position.
So Markeith Morris replaces his twin brother, Marcus. He's trying to set a high pick for Taylor, who brings it down. Morningstar's over on the right wing. Here's Reed, deep three. Yes! Two three-balls for Reed.
Nothing better against a zone that Missouri was in there, like a 3-2 zone or a matchup. Nothing better than to get a bucket right away against it.
And there's 45, influencing the shot. Defensive rebound. No basket, waved off. This is going to be an offensive foul.
Now, they got that new rule on if he is not in front of the basket, then it's not a foul. I'd like to see just where he is when he gets the contact. This is a tough rule for officials, too. Well, I see. I think he's under the bucket, and according to this new rule, that should not have been a charging foul. Now, what they have to do is put a line on the floor, because that's a very, very difficult rule for officials to follow.
You and I are in complete agreement. Use the NBA line. Just because the NBA does it doesn't mean it's bad for the college game. That has to be straightened out. Totally agree. Here's Paul on top now, playing catch out at the perimeter.
Well, they make a rule that's almost impossible
exactly
to see the rule, the line, and the contact.
Great defense by the Jayhawks. Missouri throws one up with the shot clock running down. Another defensive rebound for 45. Here's Markeith, a little bit out of control. Traveling is called.
Now that was a very poor pass right there by Morningstar. He instead of just holding the ball, he gave it up to a guy that was not in position to do anything with it.
So we'll take a break here in Lawrence, Kansas.
I'm Reese Davis. Coming up in the UPS Halftime Report, Jim Boeheim going for another 20-win season. Boy, did the Cuse protect the house after the first 3 minutes. And we'll put a little court vision on Kentucky as they get set to take on South Carolina tomorrow night.
With Bob Knight and Holly Rowe, I'm Brent Musburger. Kansas, the number two team in the nation, 38-25. And Coach Knight, let's go inside this play.
Here we're going to get a look at Kansas attacking the Missouri zone. 3-2 set up in the zone. Good pass inside. The shooter, Reed, has his feet completely set to step into the shot. It was great footwork by Reed.
Kansas with five more field goals in this game on seven fewer shots. Jayhawks hitting 52% English on a runner. And Markeith saves it. Quick outlet, and here is Collins to the attack. The pull-up. Beautiful. I got to tell you, the outlet passes that Cole Aldridge, this is the best I've seen an outlet passer in a long time in a college game.
Not just the pass, but he looks so well. He looks so well for people that are open and gets it there very quickly. Notice how he gets it above his head with both hands ready to go.
Missing the three was X back on the floor. Talented freshman from Oklahoma City, and now Missouri searching for a field goal, trailing at 40-25. They've shot 26% here. 26%.
Aldridge almost plays a one-man zone against the Missouri offense because there, Safford tried to get a shot, missed it, but Aldridge was guarding the big guy Moore, and I don't think Moore is going to shoot the ball from outside, so that lets Aldridge stay real back close to the bucket all the time, and it's tough to drive against that.
Yeah, Coach Anderson lost his firepower from a year ago. His three top scorers are gone, and it is, as you watch this team play here tonight, you can see how they struggle to find scores. They play hard for Mike, and they've got a lot of things going for them. They're very young. A couple of these youngsters are certainly going to grow up in this particular system. But going and finding a go-to shooter, Coach, you know how important that is. You had a guy through the years at Indiana. We're getting there. He's going to help us. He's going to lift us here.
Well, they don't have that at all. You're right about that. And not very often are they going to have to play against the inside defense that Aldridge gives.
Powers kicks it back outside. Safford, I should say Safford, on the run, and the foul is going to be called. Well, a reminder again, tomorrow we get a Big Ten SEC doubleheader. We've talked about Michigan State and Michigan. I want to report again that Manny Harris has been reinstated. He was suspended for the Purdue game that Coach Knight and I did in West Lafayette. And then Kentucky goes into South Carolina. Kentucky, the lone remaining unbeaten team in the nation. They're also the only team ranked ahead of Kansas right now. There are two Big East teams after that, Villanova and Syracuse. That rounds out your top four teams with the new poll just out.
Now, when I look at the scoreboard right now, Brent, and hopefully my team would be ahead. And I would look at it. We had a 15-point lead. And I'm saying to myself, we've got 2 minutes left. Let's go off the floor with 15 ahead. Let's see if we can keep our biggest lead at the halftime when we go off.
All right, let's see what happens now with the Jayhawks after giving up the free throw. Taylor to the attack, and he'll be on the free throw line shooting a pair.
Who was the release man? They had Aldridge at half court. He probably made a count of three or four to himself, and then he came up and got the release pass on the inbounds and immediately turned and got the ball going up the floor to Taylor.
You know, Aldridge has been bothered by a bit of a foot injury, and when we were in here for the California game in December, as you recall, he was not quite that active. And I said to you after, I said, you know, Bob, I was a little bit disappointed with Cole Aldridge, and it is pretty obvious that he has gotten a lot healthier since you and I saw him.
Well, if you buy a team for us, see if we can get Aldridge on it, will you?
I would think so. I'll tell you, I'm going to ask you something else. Oh, the tap back up and in. Indeed.
You've got to get your butt into that guy who has that second spot on the free throw, particularly a big kid like that. He just reached over and got the ball in.
Markieff Morris had the rebound come into his hands.
Now, I really like what Kansas is doing now. They're going to work the ball. They're going to use up some time.
Taylor misses, but Markieff is there. Still back with Taylor.
In the last 6 or 7 minutes, Kansas has really hurt Missouri on the offensive board.
It's a big week for the Jayhawks. Saturday night on ESPN, they'll be in Little Manhattan. 3-point is good as Denman knocks it down from the wing for Missouri. It's just an amazing half for Cole, Coach.
Oh, he's been everything and done everything. That was a very poor end right there to that timeout. There's Aldridge with the block, and he gets down, and there's Aldridge again. But on this last play, Taylor did a very poor job getting into the shotter. All right, there again. Missouri didn't get their butt into the guy, and he was able to go straight up with the easy tip in.
There is just no answer for number 45 on Missouri's part here tonight. Let's check in now with Holly on how much better Cole feels.
Well, guys, as you're mentioning, he's been battling some physical problems, and then last week, the death of his grandmother. When I talked to him yesterday, he said, you know, stuff has just taken a toll on me. But he said that Iowa State game last week, last Saturday, where he finally got into a rhythm. He had 11 rebounds, 19 points. And he said, I'm starting to feel like myself again. There's a look at his dad, Walter. And Cole said, one thing I do know about myself, Holly, I am going to keep working my butt off. So even though other people might be disappointed in the season he's having, he knows the kind of effort he's putting in, and it's starting to show up.
Missouri's given up the all-out pressure they've used a little bit prior to this. They're just trying to get in the way. They're trying to slow Kansas down a little bit rather than set up a press where they may end up taking the ball away.
Sharon whistles up an air ball and cannot save it. Yes, they did. Touch last by Missouri. Jayhawk basketball, and it's amazing to watch a team with a lead like this, up 15. He's got the mop. I mean, look at him helping out here a little bit, huh?
Well, that was a shot that you really don't want taken that Collins took. That was just kind of, I think, it's my turn to shoot shot.
Paul is on Sharon. Sharon a little frustrated. Takes it to the glass, tap back in, and good. Markieff Morris, number 21, credited with that basket. Morris, a 17-point lead, Coach, there up on your margin.
Well, Morris moved right into the bucket on the drive by Collins, and the ball was barely off the rim when he was there so quick to tip it in.
Here's that crowd again. Loudest we've had all year. Let's listen to him roar. Into Morning Star's hands. Working against the buzzer. Yes!
Wow, what an ending!
That was a miss for 3 points.
Throwing it up against the shot clock, under pressure, and like Coach said, look what I found. That's a take that, Quantrill. Let's check in now with Holly, with Coach Self.
Well, these guys celebrated like they just won something on that shot there, Coach, but I know you'll remind them that even though they have a big lead, there's more work to do in the second half. What will you say?
Well, that was a good shot to end the half. Good way to end it. We played pretty good. They're really fast, and I thought that offensive rebounding was great for us, and our transition defense was bad. But we'll get better at that, and hopefully just don't turn the ball over so much.
What do you have to fix on transition defense?
I'm sorry, what?
What do you have to fix on transition defense?
Well, we need to have all five guys in motion when the ball's shot, and our guards are kind of slow. And then our big guys, I've got to run better so our guards can build out quicker.
Thanks, Coach.
All right.
He's a hometown youngster. Got himself into a little bit of a jam earlier this season. Brady Morningstar, a 6'3 junior with one he'll remember for a long time. Let's join Reese Davis, Digger Phelps, and Hubert Davis with the UPS Halftime Report. Take it away, Reese. ESPN's Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, part of ESPNU Campus Connection Week on ESPN. We're at the historic Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, and the Jayhawks have opened up a big 20-point lead. Coach Knight starts us out with his full-court offense.
All right, Kansas did a great job in conversion offense, whether it came from a block shot, a rebound, a steal, whatever. Their Morningstar makes a great move to the bucket. He uses it inside. Now here comes Aldridge starting the full court offense. The break, grabs the ball. I don't think, Brent, I've seen a kid play as well around the bucket at both ends as Aldridge has tonight. Even here, you're going to see the kid mop up the floor. He does everything better than anybody else tonight.
George Hill, the stats man, said he cleans the glass as well as the floor. He's got a dozen rebounds here tonight. So here we go. Jayhawks with the first possession. And young Morningstar is trapped right away and turns it over. Back comes Missouri with an early turnover and a half. And a foul as Aldridge is working inside to kick back outside.
Missouri came out and really trapped quickly with their defense that time, and it looks like they're going to be just as aggressive as they possibly can with the defense, Brent, with trapping that early.
How about a team with a big lead like Kansas relaxing a little bit? How do you fight that as a coach?
You know, I think it's almost impossible to fight it. You know, even as a coach, you feel a little bit better with that kind of a lead. And yet, as long as Aldridge maintains the pace that he set inside, they're going to be awfully tough to play against.
And as long as Missouri shoots under 25%, they were at 25, missed that one. X misses. And underneath, Marcus Morris and Aldridge with a held ball. And this one will go over. And Holly, what did Coach Anderson have to say?
Well, you saw a little bit of it right there with Keith Ramsey. He basically said, we got killed on the boards. They were out-rebounded 37-15. That's just embarrassing. And I said, what do you do different? He said, we got to bow up. We got to go in there, use our body. And he actually showed me how to do it, bowed out his elbows and said, we got to be more physical. And then JT Tiller got his guys together and said, guys, we have got to want this. I'm not just talking about running up and down the floor. I mean, every possession, every moment, you've got to want it.
Possessions are critical to him. Ramsey, double team, comes back with this baby hook and one. So there's the persistence that Coach wanted.
Well, they had two guys fighting against Aldridge inside that time, and they eventually beat him. Aldridge stopped it twice, but you're going to see it here. There's one that he's going to get a hold of, and there's two, and now he fouls on the third one. Aldridge just has an ability to stay after defensively or offensively on the board. Either way, he just is that kind of kid that you'd love to have play for you. I don't care where you're coaching. He just contributes a lot of effort to the play.
They've turned it back over.
It's the second turnover against Missouri's pressure to start the half. This is a big bucket for Missouri.
Couldn't get it to fall into Henry's hands. Incidentally, two fouls on Aldridge. Two on Marcus Morris. Two on Sharon Collins. You're up to date now on the Jayhawks fouls individually.
Kansas.
Back here to X. Here's the three, Bob. It's going to stay.
I just started to say Kansas doesn't want to go too far without getting a bucket here into the second half. That was a very big bucket for them, even though you look at a 20-point lead. That was a good bucket.
And blocking foul. And Henry's second. So we've got four of the starters now with two fouls apiece here. And it's back to 20.
Well, you know, the kind of depth that Kansas has, that leads to much more aggressive play. You know that you're not going to get hurt by a lot of foul trouble because you've got people coming off the bench that can really play the game.
big, 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 anytime. Kim English, who was scoreless in the first half, the team's leading scorer, he's into the scorebook with that triple from the right corner.
You know, again, that was a good bucket created by an even better pass.
X again, answers at the other end.
Right where he was throwing the ball before he got it. He saw Henry in the corner, and with the ball barely touched his hands when he had it to the corner.
Nice, strong wraparound by Ramsey.
You know what Ramsey did there? He used the bucket to his advantage, Brett. He went under the bucket. Rather than give Aldridge a chance to block it on the near side, he made Aldridge come through the basket, which is very tough to do. You'll see how he uses the basket right here. I always said, use that reverse against the blocker, and Aldridge could not go through the basket to get the ball.
This foul was against Missouri on the double team in the backcourt. Ramsey, and the ball is inbounded to Marcus Morris. And now Sharon Collins will bring it to the attack in front of Bill Self's Jayhawks bench.
I think we'll see Collins bring the ball up the majority of the time here in the second half.
In deep, and a foul against Mizzou. Up over the top, and it's hard to defend.
You know, the thing that one of the physical qualities that Aldridge has is great hands. Like, that was a tough catch. He held the defensive man off, and he still got the ball and still actually was able to take it to the bucket.
Look at that, five blocks to go along with his 13 rebounds. Bob, what's interesting is how far back. Now, this is watching his hands here in underneath up over the top.
I don't even like to watch this free throw.
Because of all the moving parts.
Yeah, he moves too much. But way down, way back behind his head, and he's two for two. So I guess if I was coaching him, I probably wouldn't change it.
But you would have changed Shaquille O'Neal.
Yeah, in some way. Some way I'd have figured out a free throw.
Ramsey, not this time. Tap up. No. Missouri getting better position. Rebounding, though, to start this half. And there's a contact underneath. Tiller was digging back in on Marcus Morris.
That's already the third or maybe the fourth foul on Missouri this half.
We've had three team fouls on Kansas and now three on Missouri.
It isn't going to hurt Kansas with Missouri getting into the 1-1 early nearly as much as it would hurt Missouri if Kansas got into the 1-1 early. Don't want to throw it to that short corner. It was a great release by Morris. He got into the middle where there was no chance of a trap being set. On an inbounds against the press, Brett.
Going to reach him, tie him up again, but it'll be Kansas ball.
On that inbounds against the press, never throw the ball to the short corner. It's too easy to trap. The man playing the ball out of bounds has a quick route to the trap, but if you throw it to the opposite corner, he's got almost twice as far to go before the trap can be set. Throw it to the long corner.
Henry will bring it up. Very talented Kansas freshman. Collins, one of the seniors. Aldridge on a pick and roll. Collins keeps it, drives, kick now, and here's Henry's three ball. He's hit two already this half, and backing in was Taylor, and Collins picks up the foul. Crowd can't believe it. They shouted, they thought it should be on Taylor.
No, I think it was a good call. I think Collins got a piece of him, and I think he was just out of off balance a little bit, and that's why he got knocked out of bounds.
Collins is going to take a seat now because that's his third foul, and Tyshawn Taylor will check in for Coach Self.
Well, this isn't a press to get the ball. This is just a press to consume some time, to hassle them a little bit, to not let them get set up offensively the way they want to.
English, and a great hustling rebound. They took that one right away from Aldridge. Reset, English on the drive, and that was Aldridge, and a battle underneath. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Jayhawks. English thought he was fouled.
Safford against anybody but Aldridge, I think, in other games, league games, is going to be a very, very good inside player and an offensive threat inside. He's just not quite big or strong enough to go against Aldridge in there.
Taylor with that quickness coming down the wing. That's an offensive foul.
No, I think it's... Yeah, you're right. Yes, sir. He called an offensive foul. He kind of turned his body into the guy and then really got into him a little bit too much. Right here, you're going to see Taylor turn his body, and he had a set position. The defensive man did, and that was a good call. Well, I marvel at how alert Aldridge is. He was out on the court there. He was alert to a help position. He's alert to a help now.
Ramsey battles in on him. And that's another block for him. 7 block shots. Morningstar missed at the other end, and now they've got Ramsey out of the wing, but Aldridge has not come back. So Cole is right there defensively. Nothing easy.
Now, this is a kind of situation where you'd like to, if Aldridge is going to go outside like that, try and isolate him and drive against him. Now, that's a way that you might get him to commit a foul.
Henry going for the steal. So we're going to have a timeout, and the shot blocker tonight moves up already in the top 10. So he is now number 6.
Nuggets Spurs and Lakers Celtics, Sunday on ABC.
A sport-tuned high-flow exhaust system delivers more power. Electric power steering delivers a precise and efficient way of using it. The powerful Acura TL. The most innovative thinking you'll find in an Acura.
Take advantage of attractive lease rates on the 2010 Acura TL for well-qualified customers.
I'm Reese Davis, the SportsCenter in-game update. Cavaliers in the Heat, 1-point lead for Miami, and Dwayne Wade has the pass stolen by LeBron James, fouls him hard. Both guys stayed down for a while. Everybody stayed in the game. James made both free throws. Now, Wade has an opportunity to atone. Guarded by James. It turns out Wade is no Brady Morningstar when it comes to beating the buzzer. Cavs win it 92-91, Brent.
All right, Reese, and here Kansas maintains that 20-point advantage. It has been a long, long time since the Jayhawks and Bill Self lost a basketball game here in Lawrence. In fact, you have to go back to 2007. AC Law led Texas A&M with 24 points. And in the crowd tonight is the former Texas A&M coach, Billy Gillespie, who spent time on Bill Self's coaching staff a while back. He, of course, became the head coach at A&M, then on to Kentucky. So he is watching the game here tonight. He's the last head coach back in 2007. In 2007 and 2008, Self was 19-0. Last year, 18-0. This season, 12-0. 53 straight and working on number 54. Denman, shot clock running down.
You know one thing, Brent, as I sit here and I look at Aldridge, and how would you try to attack Aldridge? What you've got to have is a guy that is a scoring threat from the 17 to 18 foot area with the jump shot, and also a guy who has good footwork and can drive. And you've got to make Aldridge try to play against the drive rather than just being able to sit in there, but you can only do that with somebody that's a threat to shoot.
All right, Coach, here comes a Morris test. Both Markieff and Marcus are out there now, and Marcus wanted it down the low block. Henry tried to get it to him, and he finally does.
Missouri did a good job of keeping Morris outside, but they fouled him with too much help.
Which Morris?
That was your Morris.
Marcus. You know, I went to him today and I said, all right, Marcus, you and Markieff both have a lot of tattoos. Now tell me that they're a little bit different. He said, nope, identical tattoos. You can't tell us that way either. So I said to Coach Self, how do you tell them apart? He said, I don't. He said, sometimes they put on the other jersey just to, you know, a little bit. And here comes Marcus for the field goal.
Well, with your Northwestern education, I thought that it would be ideal for you to be able to determine the difference.
That's Markieff, Coach, down there working on the baseline.
He did a very good job of baseline defense right there with his footwork. Got to get out and get a little pressure.
Bowers is short on the shot into X Henry's hands knocked out of bounds. Jayhawk basketball. I don't know about you, Coach, but it's going to take a heck of an effort to beat these Jayhawks. Again, I know Tennessee did it. A little bit of a setup. And I know on Saturday night, perhaps, they've got to go on the road, down the road to Manhattan. Kansas State could be waiting for him after that tough loss at the hands of James Anderson in Oklahoma State the other night.
Well, the thing that Kansas State has going for them is that they're those two big kids that we saw, Kelly and Samuels, did a great job against Texas big people. And if they could do some of that against Kansas, it would be very good for the Wildcats.
Turn it over, Taylor did. Missouri coming back.
The odd thing in this game is right now, Kansas has 15 turnovers and Missouri has two.
Unbelievable.
It is. That's an unbelievable statistic for a team that's behind by 22 points.
So it is 9:30 here in the Midwest, 10:30 back east. With Bob Knight and Holly Rowe, I'm Brent Musburger. We welcome you to the Allen Fieldhouse. You're watching the number two team in the country, the Kansas Jayhawks, leading the Big 12, unbeaten in four conference games, lost one non-conference game in Knoxville to a fired-up Tennessee team. And here tonight, they led by 20 at the intermission, and they're still maintaining a very healthy lead. And like Bob Knight just told you, if you were listening, it's amazing how often the Jayhawks have turned it over compared with Missouri. But you don't see it in the scoring column. 15 Jayhawk turnovers already here tonight. So Coach Self can use that to tell his team they didn't play all that well. And you coaches love to do that after a win, by the way.
Yeah, you know, no matter what, it's hard to.
Marquee for the three.
You're Morris.
On a drive, English, no, short, got it back, came back, yes.
Missouri, to their credit, has certainly in no way given up. I mean, they've tried to maintain pressure defensively.
Alley oop and Marquise on fire.
Well, they didn't get back very well in conversion defense that time. Just knocked out. They kind of loafed back. Morningstar did a great job taking the ball in. And
Anderson's unhappy about it. He's just glaring at his point man, Dixon. So here is that alley-oop, Morningstar. I'm out.
I'm Reese Davis, SportsCenter right now, presented by Sprint. Brett Favre, off of that disappointing NFC Championship finish against the Saints, will not play in the Pro Bowl. He banged up an ankle, among other body parts yesterday. Tony Romo will take his place. Earlier on Big Monday, Syracuse beat Georgetown easily, 73-56. Wesley Johnson, 14-9. SportsCenter after the game. Stay current with ESPN News.
All right, Reese, well, the Jayhawks have the campus radio station, KJHK, and the play-by-play there in that red polo shirt. Kyle Larson came over, and I should say Michael Spiro is the young man there. He's doing the play-by-play, and next is Kyle Larson in the suit and tie. Next whistle, we're gonna play the end of the first half shot by Morningstar and let you listen to the youngsters. They do an excellent job, and they were excited at the end of the first half.
Kansas has improved its lead just by 3 points in about 7.5 minutes here, Brent. But one thing, when you've got a big lead at the half, if you can just maintain that lead, you're not playing too badly. It's really hard to get a team to come out with that big lead, and against a good team like Missouri, just keep it going and keep improving it.
Aldridge rebounds the miss, and back comes Morningstar, the young man who hit that buzzer beater and our first half. Both Morrises playing well. Marcus with 13.7 rebounds. Brother Markeith with 9 points and 10 rebounds.
They're going to get a good pass inside right there.
Let's go back now. We talked about Morningstar. Let's join play-by-play man Michael Spiro.
Taylor, turnaround shot, well contested, off the front iron, ahead to Brady Morningstar. Morningstar with 1 second, puts up a prayer, banks it in!
Wow.
What a shot by Brady Morningstar!
All part of Student Connection Week on ESPNU this week. Nice to have you along with us. Some great games coming tomorrow night at the Big Ten SEC. The lone unbeaten Kentucky. You'll see them tomorrow against South Carolina. Steele, there he is again. Morningstar coming down. And he'll shoot a pair.
Morningstar just smelled that pass and got in the passing lane. And before that, Kansas did a great job of doubling up on the ball screen.
Take a timeout. Jayhawks with a huge lead in Lawrence.
Winter X Games 14 kicks off as Shaun White headlines the snowboard superpipe elimination round. Then Levi LaValle goes for gold in snowmobile freestyle. Winter X Games 14 starts Thursday at 9 on ESPN.
Tonight on SportsCenter, Georgetown roars out of the gate. Syracuse tries to swing back. Can LeBron knock off Kobe, Durant, and Dwayne Wade in three straight games? Plus, Brett Favre discusses his future. Does anyone really think we're getting an answer today?
Well, the Jayhawk fans are loving tonight, beating a rival. Across state lines, Mizzou 65-42. And a reminder, tomorrow we've got Big Ten SEC. Bob, let's talk a little bit about the Big Ten. Tom Izzo, Michigan State ranked number 5. What's your feeling as they go in Ann Arbor?
Well, you know, I think that Michigan State, without any question right now, is both the best offensive team in the Big Ten and also the best defensive team in the Big Ten. And that's why they're in first place with everybody looking at them from two or three games away.
Yeah, Minnesota had a crack at them Saturday and couldn't close the deal, and so the Spartans stay unbeaten in the Big Ten. So that'll be your first game tomorrow night.
Every really good team is going to have a problem at some point during 30 games, and when they can survive that problem, that just makes them all the better.
That's 9 points for Morningstar, his first free throws of the night here.
Kansas has maintained really good defensive pressure and has been in their man-to-man defense virtually the entire ball game. Good pressure on the shooter.
And yanked down by Markeith Morris with a lead pass to Morningstar. Back comes Missouri. Three Jayhawks await them. Here's Young Dixon.
Kansas did a great job of recovering on defense that time. Conversion defense was very good.
Tiller bumps and grinds his way in, and the foul is going to be called on Henry. That's his third personal of the night. Team fouls now, 8 against the Jayhawks and 5 against Missouri. So how quickly that turned around.
Tiller got a half a step jump right there and made a little move to the bucket, and that initiated the contact, and then the foul was called, and rightly so, on the Kansas defense.
Now a little bonus free throw coming up, and Sharon Collins, who has not been at his best here tonight, checks back in.
You know, we talked about the differential in turnovers, 16 for Kansas and 4 for Missouri, but we haven't yet said Kansas has had 14 assists in this game, Brent, and Missouri's only had 6. So they've had, in that part of the ball handling, they've had a very big advantage.
Aldridge was trying to back into the low block, and the foul is going to be called. That's Moore, who was trying to defend Aldridge, was trying to keep him out of that low block.
They're set up in a zone. You can see this. They're just looking to give Kansas no cuts and make them throw it out just as they did. That, to me, is the best use of a zone defense there is. Now they're staying in the zone rather than picking up man-to-man.
Jayhawks run a little time here.
Now they got Ramsey to double up on Aldridge.
Stays with it. Loose on the out of bounds. Mizzou basketball.
Now that's the most effective double team that Missouri set on Aldridge. They kept him almost behind the basket, where it was very difficult for him to use those long arms and get up on the bucket.
Anderson's team still searching for some scores, shooting 25% here tonight. The freshman point guard, Moore, not a threat on the outside. He waits for a cutter back inside. Tiller, and Aldridge called for the foul. That's going to be the third on the big man.
Aldridge doesn't really get over, as you'll see here, and get in the line of the driver. I think we'll see. There we go. He's a little bit on the side, and he goes from the side rather than from the front and gets a piece of it.
Self with a decision to make here at the 10-18 mark. He's got a very safe lead. He has not made any indication yet. Teller knocks that free throw down, and it will be Mike Anderson who will come up, and he will send Zaire Taylor, the senior from Staten Island, New York, back onto the floor. Very impressive performance by number 12, Brady Morningstar, here tonight.
You know, you just took the words right out of my mouth. He has really been the guard that has contributed the most, both with his passing and with his shooting in this ball game for Kansas. Reed's hit a couple of threes, and there's a walk. Good call.
Markeith turns it over, and Steve Olson with that call. That's the 18th turnover by Self's Jayhawks here tonight.
Steve Olson, the kind of guy you like to see officiate, because he has a very even temperament. He understands the game. He knows that coaches are going to differ with him. He's always been one of my favorite officials.
Into Collins' hands off the Mizzou miss.
Now they're kind of back in that 2-3 zone. They're going to double up on Aldridge. But he beats a double team there with a quick move.
One of the more impressive big men in the country this year. 10 points. Got a double-double. He could get a triple-double tonight with a few more blocks.
Well, you know, tonight he's the most impressive big man that I've seen.
I agree.
Kansas still maintains good pressure. That's a shot under pressure going up on top.
And it'll go over.
Checking in the J-Hop lineup is Marcus Morris, replacing Markeith Morris.
Well, the Jayhawks, the lone unbeaten team in Big 12 conference play. Texas lost at Manhattan to Kansas State. Jayhawks will go there Saturday night. College game day with ESPN. Cameras will be there. That'll be a big night over in Manhattan. Missouri can't come back. It'll be their second conference. Now, Tyler Reed has nailed the three ball here tonight. 11 total points and 3 threes.
You know, one thing that Missouri's really going to have to look at after this game, Brent, is the fact that right now they're 14 for 55 from the floor. Now, are these the shots they wanted? Are they missing the shots they wanted? Did they have enough patience offensively? Did they get Aldridge outside where he had to guard the drive a little bit? Or was it just a poor shooting night for them? I think there are a lot of things that they need to look at relative to the kind of shot they got and how they tried to work against Aldridge. I think they can improve their shot selection. I think they can get Aldridge moved a little bit away from the basket where he has to come out on a shooter and become more susceptible to the drive. I think that's the only way that you're going to be able to play Aldridge effectively.
There's 10 fouls on Kansas now, so they'll be shooting two. And as they come down, here comes Sharon Collins, forced back on the outside. Inside of 20 seconds to go. To try to load Aldridge down low. There's that quick double back outside. And another three ball. That's his fourth of the night. By Reed for the Jayhawks. Holly, you've been listening to Coach Anderson over there. What does he want out of Mizzou?
Well, guys, just what you were following up on, Bob, is that he doesn't want his guys settling for all these jump shots like we're seeing right there. He's very frustrated that that's all Missouri's been doing. Every single timeout, he says, just drive the lane, guys. Let's see what happens. Maybe you'll get a foul called. Maybe you'll score the basket. I don't know. But why don't we just try it? This was a problem in their first half against Nebraska on Saturday, and they just haven't gotten it fixed here. I can tell you, these are not the shots Mike Anderson wants his team taking.
Now they've made a little bit of a move here. You know, they've gone up from that 20-point lead to a 28-point lead here. And if Collins hits that, which he doesn't.
And back come the Tigers now. Ball. They do try to dribble in and penetrate. Nothing doing. Collins. And It's a hell ball. And it will go over. It'll be Missouri basketball. So we will take a break. The Jayhawks in good shape. Beware the fog.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. With a just right taste that's not too heavy, not too light, the difference is drinkability. And in part by the Bruce Willis action thriller Surrogates on Blu-ray and DVD January 26th.
Well, the Allen Fieldhouse was built in 1955, and 2 years later, a youngster from Overbrook High School in Philadelphia, Wilt Chamberlain, came here, played in 57 and 58, and after his death, he still has an impact on the Kansas basketball program. He specified in his will that the Jayhawks men's basketball team continue a tradition of holding basketball clinics for area Special Olympians, and he left an endowment to take care of these Special Olympic youngsters who come out, and man, do they enjoy every year working with the current Jayhawk players. And there is the banner honoring the great Wilt Chamberlain, one of the great athletes of all time. And Sunday will host this year's clinic, and that'll be the day after the Kansas State game in Manhattan. Missouri basketball now.
Missouri just wants to see if we can get our offense going, see if we can have some patience. They're just playing to get better now, not to win a game. The game's over with, and they've just got to play to get better and to try and get some things going that they haven't had going.
This will send Safford up to the free throw line, and Aldridge has picked up his fourth personal foul.
You know, Brent, we've talked a little bit about the fact that Kansas has had so many more turnovers. Now 19 to 5, Kansas in turnovers. But also, Sherron Collins has had anything but an All-American night. And this is a kid that, in all probability, is going to be an All-American guard. He's 2 for 9, 0 for 4 from threes. He's got 4 turnovers, 2 assists. And I bring that up just to show the strength of this Kansas team. Here's a guard as good as anybody in the country who's had a very poor game, and Kansas is leading a really good team by 27 points with virtually no contribution from Collins tonight.
Will Aldridge will take a seat with the four personals. The Morris brothers back on the floor with Henry, Tyler Reed, and Collins handling the ball right now. Markeith out to set that high pick. And the Jayhawks content to bring some time down. And Bill Self, at least the other day, he didn't clear the bench. He wants these guys to get more time together, bring them together as a unit. They turn it over again, driving layup at the other end for Mizzou by Safford.
Great anticipation by Taylor on defense. He saw the only possible outlet for that pass, and he got in the passing lane, and that's how they got the bucket. That's one of those defensive plays that he should get credit for a point.
Marcus with a miss, and Henry goes to dig it out and turned it over back there, trying to tightrope walk the inline. So Missouri struggling, 25%. Their lowest previously was 33% against Richmond. Down by 25 with 6.5 minutes to go.
You know, in Coach Anderson's position, you just want to get this over with so we can get our team back home, get them together, get the plan like we know we can play. In Coach Self's position, you also want to get this thing over with. We're ahead. We've played really well. Let's don't let this thing get away from us where we end up winning by considerably less than what our biggest lead is.
Field goal by English. Markeith, Morningstar, drives, not afraid to go in there with the big bodies, and Marcus Morris is fouled. He'll come up to the free throw line. A reminder now, we've got Wednesday night hoops. We've talked tomorrow about Big Ten SEC. Well, we've got Big East ACC coming up. Notre Dame against Villanova, Florida State against Duke, and Bob, talking about Duke, they won a game on the road. They played well against Clemson on Saturday night.
Yeah, I watched a little bit of the Duke game with Clemson, and I thought they played very well. For them, it's very important that Singler and the guard play really, really good. Those two kids have got to play at their zenith for Duke to be able to compete against the better teams.
14 points. for Marcus, and he's now hit a couple of free throws. A lot of talent on this Jayhawk basketball team, and it's mature talent. Aldridge and Collins, even though he's had a bad night, he'll bounce back. He's had some great games for the Jayhawks through the years. Three ball rattles in. Nice shot by Justin Safford.
You know, now that's the second or third bucket that Safford has hit from the outside. And he just needed to be able to do that a little bit more when Aldridge was guarding him. They've not been able to bring Aldridge away. I don't think we'll see Aldridge anymore in this ball.
Well, Mike Anderson will be interested, don't you think, Bob, in how this team finishes up here. The young team, 546. He doesn't have his eye on the win prize.
Oh, yeah.
He'd like to see these kids work together.
They were down 27, and now they're down 22. And I think you can talk to your kids about that and say, okay, look, let's divide this game into segments. And the segment you want to talk a lot about was when they played the best and when they outscored the Jayhawks for at least a 3-4 minute period, whatever it might be. And we just ran into a buzzsaw tonight, and that's going to happen.
Well, our ESPNU Campus Connection takes a closer look at Missouri's Zaire Taylor. He graduated in December with a sociology degree, and one of his nicknames, Ziggy, the other one, Easy. Likes reading and writing poetry, and he also contributes with the community. Likes to read to local school children back in Columbia, and he participates in a clinic for the local Special Olympians. So congratulations to Zaire Taylor on earning that degree. Collins comes back with a left hand, and he'll shoot a pair of free throws coming to the free throw line.
Collins really forced the play there, and it was a pretty good force. One against the big kid inside. He didn't hesitate. He kept the ball away from him and had a very good opportunity for a three-point play. Now, sitting on the bench in a tight game, you're saying, okay, we had a chance for three. Let's make two.
You know, I don't think he ever had a chance outside the main part of the Allen Fieldhouse to go walk through the Kansas Hall of Fame. I did before. And I know you will agree with me. There's some great track and field athletes have come through Kansas. I've forgotten, of course, the great miler Jim Ryan. Wes Santee was here. And my all-time favorite discus thrower in history, Al Order, came out of Kansas. It was fun going back there. Of course, Gale Sayers and some of the football players like John Riggins were in the Kansas Hall of Fame. This is just a great, great building. Well, Safford comes in and misses. Bob?
Al Order was just a great athlete, was he not?
Yes, he was. He came out of retirement a couple times to win the gold medal, the discus.
I remember that.
And a foul is going to be called against Safford. And it's the hall right outside the famed Allen Fieldhouse. So you see the memorabilia that's out there, and there's pictures of everyone on the wall and the year that they have gone into the Hall of Fame. A couple of basketball coaches that certainly you know, Dean Smith. He played here. He's on a national championship team. Roy Williams, who coached here. And, of course, Bill Self will be added to that Wall of Fame. You know, Bob, I was looking at the numbers, the scoring margin for Kansas this year. They're winning by an average of 23.5 points a game. Not only is that number one in the Big 12, that's number one in the country.
Well, you know, all of that isn't against mid-level competition either. They've had some big differentials in other games beside this one tonight. And don't kid yourself, you know, Missouri, when it comes time to playing in the Big 12 tournament, NCAA selection, Missouri's going to be there.
Well, Missouri won the Big 12, I believe, last year, the tournament title, and there's a foul call. Morningstar with a blocking foul. Let's go back and take a look at some of the rankings that they are putting up. There's the scoring margin. Points per game, almost 85. And the field goal percentage, they're in the top five. I mean, all of those categories, they are in the top five in the country, not just the Big 12. I mean, we are talking about one of the elite teams here as Cole Aldridge checks back in. And Markieff Morris gets a nice round of applause. The crowd appreciates the effort that he turned in. Marcus gets a lot more minutes than Markieff. Markieff was strong tonight.
The thing that I like best in what you just showed, the graph you just showed about where Kansas stands in different areas, is opponent's field goal percentage and margin of victory. That indicates that they're playing a lot of defense.
Of course, they play Texas in Austin on Super Bowl Monday, the day after the Super Bowl. You and I will be down there. That'll be an entertaining basketball game. Texas will regroup. They went to number one and promptly lost a couple of games, but they'll be back. Great talent on that team. And of course, Rick Barnes, a coach. So,
and the day before that, we're going to have a chance to see one of the great professional athletes in history play, and that's Peyton Manning. Peyton Manning, regardless of the outcome of that game.
But we're going to be in Drew Brees' hometown. So I want you to, you know, I know how much you like and respect Bill Poley and Peyton, but I want you to be careful, Donovan. We'll watch it at home.
I will be careful, but I'm telling you, in my lifetime in sport, there's never been a guy playing that I respected any more than Peyton Manning.
Well, you had to love his performance yesterday because the Jets played a terrific first half against him. They got on him. They sacked him a couple of times in the first quarter, but he hung in. He got these other receivers involved. It was another magnificent Peyton Manning performance.
But the guy, as he plays, really understands what's happening out there.
Agreed.
You know, I'm not sure that I've ever seen a player in any sport with a better mind for what's going on than
Agreed.
He has.
Agreed. He's like a coach on the field.
No
the
question.
The way he operates. And having Jeff Saturday, a veteran center, doesn't hurt with that offensive line. They came up big yesterday, too. There's Safford knocking down a two, so it's back to 20. That was our margin at the intermission. 19 for Safford, so he's had a pretty good night here.
Well, he took Cole Aldridge outside that time, and although Aldridge had good pressure on him, it wasn't a matter of him being able to beat Aldridge on the drive, which we were talking about earlier. He just got set well and hit the shot right over top of Aldridge.
Now, Self will go a long way with his regulars. He's got Aldridge still on the floor, backing down to score again, playing with the four fouls. He gives them a lot of minutes, this group.
Aldridge has a good feel for making a fake to his left shoulder and coming back to his right shoulder, or vice versa. He knows where that defensive man is, and he always tries to take him a little further in that direction, opening up the other direction.
I got to tell you, Bob, with this performance tonight on Big Monday, Cole Aldridge goes back in the discussion about Player of the Year. This is a great performance tonight. Well, Saturday at 7 p.m., two top powers square off. Big 12 showdown. Kansas goes on the road to the Little Apple. And the Kansas State Wildcats upset. Wasn't a big upset because they were home, but they did down the number one team in the nation. And Bob, can they pull it off again against the Jayhawks on Saturday night?
Well, you know, I'll tell you one thing about Kansas State. They're going to be very strong inside. They're going to be much, much stronger inside than Missouri is with Kelly and Samuels in there. And those two guys were all the difference in their game with Texas because they just completely outplayed Texas inside game. Now, if they're as aggressive and stay out of foul trouble, they will do a lot better job inside against Kansas State than probably any team Kansas has played all year.
Well, Cole Aldridge still on the floor. He's three blocks away from a triple-double. 12 points, 16 rebounds, and seven blocks for number 45. That last block tied a young man over on the bench, a great one, Danny Manning, number five, and he's still out on top, setting the pick for Morningstar. Shot clock down inside five. Sharon steps back, fires a two. Rebound. And it is controlled by Marcus Morris. Jump pass outside. Here comes X. Battles out. Got it back again. Out hustled Paul for the long rebound. Morningstar looked quickly inside, but Missouri cut off the pass.
You know,
pass.
Even with that big deficit, Missouri hasn't lost its heart out here. They've played hard. They've really tried to get into people. I think even though Kansas had that big lead, I think Missouri has played better at both ends in the second half than they did in the first half.
There's X driving in and offense. Foul on Henry. So Cole Aldridge tied now for fifth with one of the assistant coaches over there. Danny Manning, who someday certainly will be a head coach, works hard with the youngsters in practice back in 88, playing for Larry Brown. Danny and the Miracles won a national championship, beat Oklahoma in the final, and a member of the Kansas Hall of Fame. And if he hadn't injured that knee early, Bob, in the NBA, I really think he would have been one of the all-time greats in the NBA. He was just a wonderful basketball
He could really
player.
Handle the ball. He was a great passer. He could score, rebound. Yeah, I think you're right. He was a tremendous player here at Kansas.
Driving the baseline, the foul is called. Always was such a fine young man to deal with. I remember that year or two. He's for the media. I always enjoyed being around him there. Of course, the years in 88. Kansas wins the national championship. Hung down 2008. We got another banner under Bill Self, and they're going to be one of the favorites come March Madness. They stay healthy and play like they did here tonight. And, of course, we'll see what they come up with on the road against Frank Martin.
You know, among the better teams, I look at the better teams that you and I have seen, I obviously think that Syracuse has won. And Syracuse has got some inside strength that could create a matchup that would be good for them with Kansas. But there just aren't many teams that can match Kansas inside play with the Morris twins and with Cole Aldridge. I think that's an advantage they have against a lot of the better teams.
We were just with Purdue, and they would be a little short in underneath. Juwan Johnson had to battle away all night.
Well, but you know, Hummel and Johnson can both shoot the ball a little bit, so they're going to be people that probably take it outside and make Aldridge play them outside.
Robinson is fouled. And that foul is going to be on Zaire Taylor.
Foul number 11, Zaire Taylor, his second personal foul.
So they head for 54, and it's interesting to see the total. Look how far they have separated for number two, Siena, and look who's number three. Remember now, Missouri beat Kansas over in Columbia last year. They have the third longest home winning streak in the country. And here is Bill Self about to put up number 54 in a row. Into Taylor's hands. Back come the Tigers now inside of 2 minutes here. Safford and Robinson rebounding for the Jayhawks. Comes away quickly.
Robinson did a good job getting rid of the ball to somebody much better at bringing it up than he would be.
Elijah Johnson, young man with a great future for Kansas, number 15 freshman from Las Vegas, is now on the floor, and here's that hot in chant. Go back the other way before the shot. Another rock shot. Jayhawk, kind evening here in Lawrence, and some of the good fans are finally headed for the exits. They know this one's in the W column.
A lot of satisfied fans leaving the arena here in Lawrence tonight, Brent.
Indeed. And some disappointed Mizzou fans. But a good young team, and certainly they'll be back. They have played hard here tonight. They just did not shoot the ball well at all. And they were never able to really take Kansas out of any kind of a rhythm. Jeff Withey, the transfer from Arizona, has got the ball in the low block, and he has stripped. And coming up to the free throw line, he became eligible at the end of the semester. And he's a seven-footer now. You know, come tournament time, having a seven-footer, an extra one who can give you a few minutes off the bench can be invaluable if you run into some of that size that you're talking about.
No question. And what we've seen here tonight also, Brent, is that Kansas has an inside capability that centers around Aldridge that really no other team has. And I think that's been something that Missouri has had to contend with. That and their overall defensive play, much better than anything they've played against so far this year.
Tehan under pressure, missed that shot. Missouri will come down, try to get inside that 20-point margin if they can, and the foul goes against the Jayhawks, and it's on with it. So Missouri comes up to the free throw line, trailing by 21 right now. The final seconds for Bill Self. And then he'll enjoy the moment for a few hours here tonight. He'll probably go out to the Salty Iguana. That's where his radio show is. See his buddy Dan Chandler out there. They'll enjoy this one for a few hours tonight. And then got to get ready for that tough one in Manhattan against the Wildcats. That will not be easy.
You don't have a lot of time to relax if you're going to do a good job coaching. You get into the locker room, you talk a little bit about the game, you look at the tape, you look at the film, take notes on the film, and then you start preparing for the next one.
So we've got a 30-second timeout here. So here are the Tigers' next few games as they go back home and regroup. And they'll play Oklahoma State and Texas A&M before they go back on the road. So it will not be easy against either of those teams, Oklahoma State and Texas A&M, but at least they'll have some home cooking.
This has really been a game where Missouri has never looked like they were going to have a shot at Kansas in this game. And sometimes that happens, and I really think tonight is one of those nights.
You're going pheasant hunting again tomorrow?
Next 2 days.
The bus won't be the same without you going back to West Lafayette. We'll miss you.
That's okay. You know, I'm going with my good friend from Dodge City, Jim Lewis, and I got to make a comment here. I'm supposed to call a doctor friend of mine back in Indianapolis that's helped me with a bad finger, and he gave me a cortisone shot. So anybody talks to Doc Strickland, tell him I'm doing better.
Is that your trigger finger, coach? There it is, Bill Self in Kansas, 84-65, 54 and counting. For more on this game, tune in to ESPN News
for
post-game extra. Up next on ESPN Sports Center, I'm Brent Busberger. For Bob Knight, Holly Rowe, and our entire crew, this has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. So long from Lawrence, Kansas. Hit that switch. Will you hit that talk back? Come on now. So long, everybody.